everybody. Listen. What a beautiful day we're here now. Thank you. Thank you. I want to begin by thanking a number of people who helped out today. First of all, Reverend Douglas Thunder for the invocation. Tina Keeley for the Pledge of Allegiance. Thank you, Tina. Anne Marie Evans for the National Anthem. And I want everybody to know that Jill Derby is running for Congress, and we need her in Washington. I also, some of you know that I've been off the trail for a day, and I just want to personally say how grateful I am. There are so many people who sent out their thoughts and prayers and sent my grandmother flowers and getting roll cards, and I just want you to know, it meant the world to her. It means the world to me. Thank you, everybody, for being so gracious. It's really nice. Thank you. It means a lot. It means a lot. You know, Nevada, in 10 days, you will have the chance to elect your next president. You will have the chance to bring the change we need so desperately to Washington. Now that's the good news. But we're going to have to work. We're going to have to struggle and fight for every single one of those next 10 days to move our country in a new direction. We can all let up, and I know we won't. Because one of the things we know is that change never comes without a fight. In the final days of campaigns, the say-anything, do-anything politics all too often takes over. We've seen it before, and we're seeing it again now. The ugly phone calls, the misleading mail and TV ads, the careless, outrageous comments, all aimed at keeping us from working together. All aimed at stopping change. That's not what we need right now. The better the American people don't want to hear politicians attack each other. What you want to hear about is how we're going to attack the challenges facing middle-class families each and every day. What we need right now is honest leadership and real change. And that's why I'm running for President of the United States of America. Now, this is a moment of great uncertainty for America. The economic crisis we face is the worst that we've seen since the Great Depression. Businesses, large and small, are finding it impossible to get loans, which means they can't buy new equipment or hire new workers, or even make payroll for the workers that they have. We've lost more than 750,000 jobs this year so far. And unemployment here in Nevada is up 30% from last year. Wages are lower than they've been in a decade, at a time when the cost of everything from healthcare to college have never been higher. It's getting harder and harder to make a mortgage, or fill up your gas tank, or even keep electricity on at the end of the month. At this rate, the question isn't going to be, well, you're better off than you were 4 years ago. The question is, are you going to be better off than you were 4 weeks ago? So what we need right now is a real debate about how to fix the economy and help middle-class families. But that's not what we're getting from the other side. A couple of weeks ago, my opponent's campaign said, I quote, if we keep talking about the economy, we're going to lose. So they said that they would be focusing the last couple of weeks on attacking me instead. And I have to say that that's one campaign promise that they've actually kept. Senator McCain has been throwing everything he's got at us, hoping something will stick. He's called me a socialist for suggesting that we focus on tax cuts not for corporations and the wealthy, but for the middle class. Then, the other day, he took it to a whole new level. He said that I was, get this, like George W. Bush. You can't make this stuff up. In what may be the strangest twist of this campaign, that's had a lot of strange twists, John McCain said that I would somehow continue the Bush economic policies, and that he, John McCain, were changing. He denounced the president for letting things get completely out of hand. That's what he said. That's why John McCain's been really angry about George Bush's economic policies, except in the primaries when he said that we've made great progress economically under George Bush. At this last month when he said that the fundamentals of our economy are strong under George Bush. In fact, John McCain is so opposed to George Bush's policies that he voted more than 90% of the time for the first 8 years. That's right, he decided to really stick it to George Bush 10% of the time. Be clear. John McCain attacking George Bush for his out-of-hand economic policies like Dick Cheney attacking George Bush for his going along foreign policy. What Joe Biden says is like, it's like Tano getting mad at the Lone Ranger. John McCain's been with Bush every step of the way. Every step of the way. Personally, President Bush doesn't seem to be all that offended. Because yesterday he cast his vote early for, guess who? John McCain. And that's no surprise, because when it comes to the policies that matter for middle-class families, there's not an inch of daylight between George Bush and John McCain. Like George Bush, John McCain wants to keep giving tax breaks to companies that ship jobs overseas, and oil companies, and CEOs. It's the same failed Wall Street first, Main Street last economic policy that we've seen over the last 8 years, and we are going to change it on November 3rd. Like George Bush, John McCain wants to tax your health care benefits for the very first time in history. Let insurance companies keep discriminating against people who need health care the most. It's the same failed insurance company first, your family last health care policy, and we're going to change it on November 3rd. Like George Bush, John McCain wants to privatize part of Social Security. Leave it to the whims of the marketplace. Like George Bush, John McCain ignored this housing crisis until it was too late, and then proposed a $300 billion bailout for Wall Street banks that does hardly anything to help people stay in their homes. Like George Bush, he wants